Cupcakes, it's me again, Tyler Morgan Banks here. Okay, now let's get right into this look. So of course you already know that the Aaliyah line has come out. Shout out to all the people that actually signed the petition for this to come to life, just like we did with the Selena. I actually have part of my Selena line, so yeah, I think I signed both petitions on change.org, so shout out to everybody that did that. We made it come true, guys. You did it. So Cupcakes, I didn't get all of the line, but I did try to show you, you know, everything that was in it. There's a lot of great videos showing everything that was in it, but you know, I'll do my part and show you some of the swatches that I took. Just a picture of what everything looks like. But for the most part, I'm just gonna use what I got because I actually just started off and just bought, you know, what I was gonna use for my look. So now, Aaliyah is one of my favorite singers. I love Aaliyah. I am a singer, so I really get her style. When I thought of Aaliyah, I thought like really, really cool colors, cool tones. I thought, you know, gray, I really kind of thought kind of monochrome a little bit. So, you know, just from looking at her videos and just her style, you know, Aaliyah honestly didn't really wear a lot of makeup. Like, she had certain videos, you know, where she was made up or whatever, but just that wasn't her image. Her image wasn't like, you know, over glam how we do it. So you kind of got to tone it down a little bit if I'm really trying to capture her. But I kind of wanted to use all of the palette, so I used everything from the line. So I got the palette, I got a bunch of lipsticks, I got the liner. I didn't get a bunch of lipsticks. Let's just start from here. So what I did end up getting, and you have to excuse my fingerprints, that's why I hate like not waiting until I open it for you guys, but I couldn't wait, so I opened it anyway. So it has a lot of fingerprints on it, so hopefully you can't see it, but I love the packaging. The packaging is so pretty. That's why you get these sets, so you can actually have the packaging. I think this is just gorgeous. I love that color. And when I look at her pictures on Pinterest and, you know, just all of her album work, I feel like they really did good to actually capture Aaliyah, because she did wear a lot of dark lipsticks, but her eyeshadow just wasn't as heavy as we wear it now. But I still feel like they did a great job actually capturing her. Big ups to Matt for doing that. First of all, I bought the palette. As you can see, I was playing in it. So they have all the cool tones here. Got the silver, this other looking color. They didn't have names on it like a lot of MAC eyeshadows do, but you know, that's okay. I really feel like this is really cute to take with you as well, because they have a lot of pretty colors. And I've seen a lot of beauty influencers use the gold. So I want to do it completely different, and I'm just going to try, and hopefully I remember what I did, because I did practice, but I do remember some of what I did. So my key for this look was, like I said, to capture Aaliyah. Aaliyah was really cool. She was, I think, of gray, I think monochrome, I think silver, I think, you know, things like that. So I'm going to go ahead and get right into this look. So we've already done eyebrows. I've already primed my eyes with my concealer and my transition powder. I always tap a little white powder, white setting powder on my eyes. I always tap a little powder on there because I don't like it being wet, so I just tap a little powder on there. So the very first thing I did, I'm gonna use this silver right here. So guys, I don't know if my camera cut off, but I'm taking this again. I've already wet my brush with my MAC Fix Plus. And this is Royal & Lane Nichols Medium Shader Brush. And so I'm going to take, you know, when you wet them, they kind of, you know, turn foilish. They just stand out more. So I wet it and I'm placing it straight in the middle, straight down. Here we go. I'm just taking it straight down. And I really want it to stand out, so I'm just going to, you know, keep spraying it. Next, I'm going to go ahead and take this color right here. There, and I'm gonna place it on my outer V, on my outer corner, and I'm gonna make a V shape. Kind of bring it in just a little bit. And this is my Royal & Lane Nichols. I really like them. This is from the Revolution line, and this is BX66. It's a really good, blending brush. You can never have too many blending brushes to me. I love those. I'm going to take a more precise brush that's kind of flat and just tap that same color here. Tap it, you know, in the inner corner. So I'm going to take the same color. I'm just going to put it here. Not going up too far. Okay, now I also like this brush to go in the inner corner because it's kind of slant, which kind of helps me follow my eye shape as well. Because if you notice, what I'm trying to do here is make this curve here, make this line to follow my eye shape instead of putting it like straight down, because then it would be boxed. Ooh, ooh. Okay. I also really, really, really like 90s music, by the way. Who doesn't like 90s music? 90s was just the best. 80s was pretty good too, but I really, really like 90s. Some of my favorite groups are there. Number one, you had Aaliyah, you had Jodeci. Whoa, 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 whoa. Forever, forever, forever. Hey! So I'm just blending in here. Blend, 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 and again, my friend. I just added something. And so just to give it a tad bit more depth, I'm gonna add this dark brown color here, which actually shows up a little bit darker, and I'm gonna put it on the outer corner just to add more depth to the look. And I've kind of seen Aaliyah wear this look before. I think it's in her More Than a Woman video. I've actually seen like these colors being used, so I pulled my inspiration from, you know, those, and just Aaliyah's entire look in general. My Master Precise, while I'm twiddling it, I'm using my Master Precise by Maybelline because I absolutely love this. I feel like if you're a beginner, because this tip is so sturdy, I feel like, you know, it'll be really good for you. So I'm just gonna wing it out. I'm gonna wing a little bit just to give it depth. I'm not gonna do a whole, you know, whole length. Not a whole lot of wing. Whatever, just a little. Okay, so moving on to my highlight and contour. Before we do the lips, because I did something a little different with the lips, I just, you know, just moved to do it. So I'm going in with the LA Girl Pro Concealer, and these are the cream concealers. Now I'm going in with, let's see, this is medium deep. I like the highlighting color on here because it's not too bright, but it's not too yellow either. Because, you know, I don't like the super gold look, but then I also don't want it to be too light for me. So I have this one for the actual highlight, but then I also don't like to look too warm on my contour. So I got this one in deep because I felt like the contour here was just better for me. It's, you know, if you look at it, you can see the difference. You can see the difference. One is warmer than the other in the highlight and the contour. So I like the way one looks in the other one. So I'm just gonna do that. Decided to switch because I didn't like what it was coming out. So one of my favorite contours is the contour stick by Anastasia Beverly Hills. This is called Earth. So I'm gonna take this. See, that shows up a lot better. Yeah, I really like the way that shows up. And I'm not dragging while I move. I'm not dragging the product along. I'm pressing and moving it. The way it just really, you know, kind of conceals and gets into the skin. Move this down and kind of blend out that line where your highlight and the contour meets, I kind of just blend that out in the middle. And by now, everything is looking clean and seamless. So what I'm gonna do is set this entire look. Let's use the beauty, okay, whatever. I really like these wedges because it allows me to just move the product and place it where I want to without making a mess. So I'm gonna dip that in the Beauty Bakery and I'm gonna place it all up in here. All up in here, all up in here. I'm going all the way up. Okay. Ooh, I just really like this finish. It's so soft. Look at that. It's really soft. Pretty. But I really like my makeup to look as natural as possible, but I also like for it to look bold. So I give you, you know, really bold looks, but that's also wearable. You know, I don't want to look like a really pretty made-up clown, you know what I mean? Because I still want to look really bold, but I still want to look really dainty as well. Like, my style is really dainty. It's really girly. You know, it's really just seamless, but it's also like, bam. Ooh, that's cute. It's like fierce, like Tyra used to say on, what was that show? America's Next Top Model, yeah. Like, she used to say fierce, you know what I mean? It looks fierce. I want to try to look as fierce as I can, but I don't like the looks that's just like, over, this is too much. It's like, I'm not really gonna wear that because I'm gonna be hot while I make it on my face. I'm liking how this is coming together. Okay, anyway, you guys, excuse my nails aren't done. Like, I'm going through a transition right now because I literally, all the last set I had, I ripped them off because I got tired of the needle on my nails. Don't ever do that. Don't ever do that. Don't rip nails off of your fingers, okay? You will mess your cuticles up and you will mess your nail bed up. They are messed up. Mine have finally grown out, but this look would be so much better if my nails was on fleek, but whatever. Okay, so taking this powder brush by e.l.f. I'm going in with my favorite bronzing powder, which I promise to bring you a very luxurious bronzing powder for all you brown girls when I get ready to have my line. Anyway, okay, so I'm just gonna place this here. And that contour that we did, I'm just gonna do that there. Yeah, I'll just do that. Ooh, look how seamless that is. Okay. And you know, I kind of take that contour powder and just kind of go over my highlights just a little bit, just to tone it down a little bit because I don't want it, you know, all over the place. I don't want to look too bright. Like, I just want it to look like it all flows, you know. So honestly, what I do sometimes, what I'm gonna do today, is just take this big brush. This is Royal and Lanicle. This is on their Silk line. This is the Dome Powder Brush, C135. This in my actual foundation shade from MAC is NC50, and I'm gonna put it in this powder, and I'm gonna put that all over my face. Just to make it look, you know, seamless. So the highlight is still under there because I don't want to lose it, but I don't want it to be overdone. Lastly, I'm gonna take this. I actually got this brush off eBay. It's from Vander or something like that. I was just trying out a bunch of brushes. And, you know, really just to see the difference was, because a lot of that stuff is private labeling. Like, I bought a whole brush set. For like $9. It came with like 12 pieces and I wanted to see it. And I'm gonna show you what it looks like. It looks like this. Now, who do you know? I got the whole set off eBay for $9. Who do you know just took these brushes and put them in the store? I want you to tell me. Because literally, if I have not seen another example of private labeling, as I have with that. Like, that was my own witness. That was straight up private labeling. Like, you didn't give me anything different except your name. I'm gonna let you think about that. So don't sleep on eBay or Amazon. For the highlight, I'm gonna go on with my MAC, and this is Soft and Gentle. This is Mineralized Skin Finish, and I'm just gonna place it. Well, that's right there. Because I felt like it would go really good with this look because it's really cool. I'm lining my lips with Aaliyah's Never This Color Is Nevermore. I'm gonna use both of these. And usually when you use both, you put the lighter one on top and the darkest one on the bottom. But I felt like switching it up. So I'm gonna do one in a million, which is the darkest out of these two with the blue sparkles. I'm gonna put the darkest one on top and the lightest one on the bottom. And I just wanna see how it looks. So. Now we're just gonna leave it like that. All right, now before my battery goes dead, let's finish the entire look. All right, cupcakes, and this is the end of the look. So far, I'm very proud of it. I really like it. I wish I had a few more things, but I really felt like I captured Aaliyah in this, and I really wanted to get it out. So, I hope you all enjoy the look. If you want to see more, make sure you subscribe and become a cupcake here at the Tyler House, where we have everything and the door is always open for you. I got my ring and my necklace and, you know, my little earring. So, I really hope I captured Aaliyah here. But anyway, if you enjoyed, make sure you like and comment down below what you liked about it. Tell me what you liked about the line, if you bought the line or if you didn't, even if you signed the petition. So, you know, just make sure we get to know each other here at the Tyler House. But anyway, guys, head on over to my singing channel because I will be posting a video of me singing using this look. And I hope you enjoy that as well. Follow me on Instagram and Snapchat. I'm on Snapchat as well. So, but I'm mainly on Instagram. Well, I don't know which one I'm on more. I don't know. I'm on both of them. Those are my two main social media sites. And if you have any questions or if you'd like for me to use your music in my actual videos, make sure you let me know that either through my email or Twitter. So anyway, guys, I hope you enjoy this look. Shout out to Aaliyah. Make sure you still rest in peace. We love her music. And yeah, guys, make sure you come back. Love you. Kisses.